Hello, friends. Welcome to this week's Sacred Moments. It has been said that the higher goal of spiritual living is not to amass a wealth of information, but to face sacred moments. And that is what our desire is for you today, to experience a sacred moment, one that you can savor throughout the day, one that reminds you that God is alive and active in your life. So let us pray. Lord, give us the insight to recognize the sacred moments you offer to us as we draw closer to you through them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus came to save us from sin. In other words, He came to save us from self-centeredness. Put the word self-centeredness instead of the word sin in the New Testament, and you'll see what meaning comes up in many passages. For sin shall not have dominion over you becomes self-centeredness shall not have dominion over you. That's God's desire for His people. And yet, if we examine our lives, we'll find that even our most sacred desires, there is still self-centeredness. To ask God to fill us with the Holy Spirit can be a self-centered desire if we want this power in order to be somebody great in the church. That's as self-centered a desire as wanting to be great in this world. Do you see how sin enters even into the most holy place? That's why Jesus taught us to pray, first of all, not even that we might be filled with the Spirit, but that God's name might be hallowed.
Jesus, I surrender all to Him. I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him in His presence. I surrender all.
Only a true spiritual man can pray the Lord's Prayer in sincerity. Anyone can repeat this prayer, of course. Even a parrot can do that. But to really mean it from the depths of our hearts will require a total devotion to God, where He is first in our lives, where we are centered in Him, and where we are not seeking His blessing as much as Himself. If He gives us His gifts, well and good. And if He does not give us any gifts, that's all right with us as well, because we long for God Himself and not His gifts.
Sensitivity to Him is gone. I've run the race, but set my own pace and face a shattered soul. Now the gentle arms of Jesus warm my hunger to behold. Soul, I want to know you. Oh, I want to know you, to feel your heart and know your mind. Looking in your eyes stirs up within me cries that say, I want to know you. Oh, I want to know. Death and resurrection. Oh, I want to know.
Why did God teach the Israelites to love Him with all their hearts and to love their neighbor as themselves? Only to deliver them from their self-centeredness. There is an acrostic on the word joy that says, put J, Jesus, first, O, others next, and Y, yourself last. Then you can have joy. God is perpetually full of joy. There is no sorrow or anxiety in heaven because everything is centered in God. The angels are always rejoicing because they are centered in God. The reason we lack joy and peace and so many other spiritual virtues is because we haven't found our proper center. We tend to use God for our own ends. Our prayers reveal how self-centered we really are. Delight in the Lord, the Bible says, and He will give thee the requests of thy heart. To delight ourselves in the Lord is to put God at the center of our lives. And so it is only a God-centered person who can have all the desires of his heart. He will not deprive of good things them that walk in innocence. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusteth in thee. For the continual prayer of a just man availeth much, and the just man is the God-centered man. On the contrary, the continual prayer of the self-centered man, even if he prays all night, is going to avail nothing. It is the type of life we live that gives value to the prayer we pray. That's why the first three longings of our life should be, Father, your name should be hallowed, your kingdom should come, and your will should be done. We may have many other requests, such as, heal me of my backache, help me to find a better house to live in, help my son to get a job, etc. These are all good requests. But if you can say, Father, even if you don't grant these requests, my primary desire is that your name will be glorified, then you're a spiritual man.
Dark and dreary,
I hope you enjoy these sacred moments we have together each week. If you would like to contact us with any questions or thoughts you may have, email us at vaticaninexile@gmail.com. We would love to hear from you. And lastly, let me leave you with this thought to ponder. There is nothing more irreligious than self-absorbed religion.